Morning friends, I am Aryan of Sanskriti Global School, Vishakapatnam. Studying in 8th class is here to say a topic about divisibility rules from number 2 to 12. So there are some numbers from 2 to 12 which are whose divisibility rules are easy to remember. Those numbers are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10 and 12. The numbers which are having divisibility rules which are hard to remember are 7 and 11. So first I am going to complete these numbers. Then I will proceed to numbers which are hard to remember. So first the divisibility rule of 2. 2 is an even prime number, and you know that every number, every even number is divisible by 2. So there is nothing but, there is a small divisibility rule for this 2. That is, if any large or small number ending with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, means all the even numbers, then that number is divisible by 2. For example, I'll take 220, 222. Here, the number ends with 2. That means it should be divisible by 2. You can do it by 2 1s are 2. 1s are 2. And then again 2 1s are 2. If we take any small example like 36, then 2 1s are 2, there will be a remainder 1, and 2 8s are 16. So we can see that any number ending with 0, 2, 6, 4 and 8 can be divisible by 2. So now let's proceed to number 3. Number 3 and number 9 have the same divisibility rule. So that rule says that when we sum up all the digits of a number, it should be equal to the multiple of 3 or 9. So I'll say an example to understand this easier. Example, we'll take 369. When we sum up all these numbers, we get 18. 18 is divisible by 3. 3 6 are 18. So the whole number is divisible by 3. We can check like this. And luckily, this number is also divisible by 9 because the number 18 is a multiple of 9. 9 2 is 18. So we can also use 9 to divide this number. So I'll say about 4 and 8 together. They have a little similar divisibility rules, but not totally same. In 4, what's the divisibility rule? If a number, like if a number is given to you and the end 2 digits are divisible by 4, like 1s and 10s place is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. For example, 4, 24. We all know 24 is divisible by 4. 4 6 are 24. So let's see this works or not. 4 1s are 4. 2. So we cannot do it. 24. 4 6 are 24. So here this is the divisibility rule of 4. Divisibility rule of 8 is the ending 3 digits should be divisible by 8. Like 10's place, 1's place and 100's place should be divisible by 8, then the whole number is divisible by 8. For example, 4008. we know these three numbers. Here 8 is divided by 8. So 4008 is divided by 8. Let us check. It's a 40, so 0. 8 once an 8. So I have proved it, it's divisible by 8. 4 and 8 is completed. Now I'll like to move on 5 and 10. So 5 has a divisibility rule. Let in one's place if 5 and 0 is present, then the whole number is divisible by 5. And for 10, if the ending digit, means one's digit, is 0, then every number is divisible by 10. For example, let's take 550. Here, according to the definition, it should be divisible by 10 and 5 both, because the ending is 5, it's divisible by 5, and the ending is 0, so it's also divisible by 10. So 5, 1 to 5. 5 ones are 5 and 0. So it is divisible by 5. Now let's see 10. 10 5s are 50. 10 5s are 50 again. Remain to 0. So it is also divisible by 10. I think we have completed all the numbers except 12, 11 and 7. So we will complete that now. So let's begin with 12. So 12 is equal to 3 into 4. So any number which is divisible by 3 and 4 is divisible by 12. For example, small examples I take 24. 12 2s are 24. Now we should see if it is divisible by 12 or not. So 8s are 24. And then with 4, 4 6s are 24. So 24 is divisible by 12. So now let us proceed to 11 and 7, which is the toughest ones of all these. So let's start with 11. For solving 11's divisibility rule, we'll use a method called odd even numbers. This is odd even method. We call it odd even method in short terms. So let's take an example. This example. So first we'll start with odd and continue like consecutive, odd, even, odd, even, odd, even, like that. So odd, even, odd, even, odd. Now take all the odd numbers one side and take all the even numbers one side and sum up them. 1 plus 3 plus 1. It answers 5. And 2 plus 2. 4. Now we have to subtract these two, means the odd part and the even part, we have to subtract them. 1. So whenever the answer comes 11 and 0, then the number is divisible by 11. So one example I give, which is correctly divisible by 11. We can take 594. Odd, even, odd. Let us take all the odd sides together and add up 9 and the 9 here. So when we subtract them, we get 0. So it is divisible by 11. Now you must be thinking, this is an odd number, why am I taking even? We are not depending like it is odd and we are keeping on that odd. Only normally for the casualty we are taking odd, even, odd, even, odd. It's not like 4 is odd number and 9 is even number. We are not taking such a way. Normally, odd, even, odd, even, odd, even, odd, and we have to separate them, sum up them, and subtract. This is 11. Divisibility rule of 11. Now, divisibility rule of 7. 7, there is no specific name for this method, but in this, the main thing is subtracting. When we do so, think, take a number. We should take the last digit of the number, double it, and subtract with the leftover number. Minus 2. We double the 1. 1 into 2. So 2. 1, 2, 3, 0. Now again take the last number. Double it, subtract. So 0, 2 is 0. 123. Take the 3, again double it and subtract. 12 minus 3, 2 is 6. So we get 6 as answer. So when the answer comes as 0 or 7, then the number is divisible by 7. So in this case, this number is not divisible by 7 as we are getting 6. So this is the divisibility rule of 7. With this I am concluding my thing, and thank you for watching my video.